Sometimes you hear someone's, after listening to someone sing or speak or play an instrument, the person who observed it would say, "Man, I wish I could do it like that. I wish I could play the piano or sing or speak like you do." And I would say to those that I knew personally that don't covet the gift, because then you'll have to experience what they went through to get it. You might build on it, like they build on blues, but nobody wants to go back to black codes and Jim Crow laws and slavery and all the stuff that came in the belly of African slaves and sharecroppers and people that built a foundation of music that would span the blues and R&B. That came from a place that, they sang about what they know about, and it was deep and it was so powerful, people could build on it generations later. But they can't go back and experience it because they won't know the pressure. They won't know the heat that person went through. They don't won't know how long that was just buried on the inside of them till it kind of erupted or came forth. So it is with a diamond. A diamond is a process. It has to You have to bury the carbon dioxide in the Earth's mantle about 100 miles underground, and then you got to apply this intense amount of heat, 200 and or 2,200 degrees Fahrenheit, and then put all of this pressure, like of 7,500 pounds of pressure per inch. Wow, to come up with a diamond. And I tell you know, and a diamond is beautiful, but Jesus would say in Matthew that, you know, that how beautiful we are, that even with all the riches that King Solomon had, how beautiful we are, because we have this opportunity to have God live in us in a very unique way at how he designed us. And we can't see the brilliance. You know, sometimes you look at a baby, and when you have a love mentality, you look through love eyes and you see the brilliance. But sometimes, if it's a rough place in a person's life, you don't see that diamond being formed because you don't have the same eyes God has. You don't understand. And when you see the pressure they go through, you'd like to take them out of that. But, you know, it was good that I was afflicted, that I may know the statutes of the Lord. So it's even something about the fire we go through that brings us forth as pure gold, that burns off the tin off the dross off the silver. It's something about the pressure we go under that we don't want to do it. Nobody wants to. But even if when you're building, when you're body building, you got to put some pressure on that muscle just to clean out, just to push toxins out and get that muscle to grow. You know, so that's just how it is. And it takes time, and it's a process. And your process is not my process. My process is not your process, but it's a process. And in this process, we have somebody in the fire with us. We have somebody that comes besides us and takes up the pressure, you know, takes off some of the pressure on the yoke. It says, "Take my yoke upon you, for my burdens are easy, and, you know, my yoke is light." And so we have someone in that process with us. So the same God who made all of creation has a wonderful plan to bring you forth as pure gold. And he's given you all the help you need. Jesus said, "I've completed the work. Now just sit in me in Christ Jesus, and God will will his will in you. All we have to do is trust and obey, because there's no other way to be happy in Jesus." And he sends us paraclete to lead us into the truth of who we really are, so we can see ourselves with love eyes. And when we have love on the inside of us, we can look at other people with love, you know, getting the love from God, so we can love our neighbor as ourselves and please God. Because it's impossible to please God without faith. And faith works by love. And God is love. So it's got to all come together. And in this love, sometimes it's pressure. You know, love is not easily offended. To deal with the offense, bears all, believes all. That's pressure. Hopes all. That's pressure. It's in the fire when you have to, you know, let some stuff just burn off of you, you know. That process of love is almost like a diamond, but it doesn't take as long because God is on the inside working on the outside, bringing about a change in our life. And when he looks at us and he sees his son, the sun, the bright and morning star, that sparkle, you know, that bling, we need to get that love bling in us through Christ. And my process is not your process, but please, let's all be encouraged in the process. Sorry about all the noise behind me, but you got the gist. God bless you real good.